Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne. We got some metal art again for you today from the folks over at Moyustore. If you remember, we created the mechanical wasp that you see here and in this video here. Absolutely amazing piece of artwork, that is. We're going to now build a mechanical octopus. Now, as you can see in this picture here, this is an amazing piece of artwork, but it's not just an octopus. It actually holds things like an echo dot or a lamp. Or in the case of this video today, we're going to be putting in a moon. And this moon actually changes colour, although you're not going to be able to see that on stream. That's why I've done this little video for you, just to show you what this actually looks like. Now, I think this video is going to be done over two sides, because we've got the bottom half of the octopus to do, and then we've got the top half. So I think today we're going to do the bottom half, which does mean we've got to build eight legs, and that's where we're going to be starting from today. So I'm going to introduce you to this kit. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put the link in the video description, and there's also a discount code in there where you can get some money off if you order this from the folks over at Moyustore. So without further ado, let's get cracking. Now, the whole lot of this comes in this tin. As you can see, this is what we're building here, and it does come with instructions. All the parts for this are in their own individual bags, as you can see, and they are all numbered, so we know what bags we're actually using. But I will show you as we go along what we're doing. Here's a bag of tools. We also get a screwdriver, which looks just like that, so we're going to need those. This especially for tightening up the nuts that we've got for this section. But as you can see, there is quite a few bags for this build. So now here are the instructions, and basically we're going to be working our way pretty much today until we get to this point here where we're mounting all the legs onto the central spindle. So the first thing we've got to do is we've got to make a leg, and then we've got to do that eight times. Once we've done that, we're going to be doing the middle section and then creating the head section. And if I turn this over, as you can see, the head section, which finishes on these bits of instructions here, is then able to hold an object around about this big, so it can be, as I said, an echo dot, a lamp, and in our case we're going to be putting a moon, and that looks just like that. But this is a bit of artwork to what this amazing bit of mechanical art looks like. So I'm going to get out the first parts that we need, and it's basically we've got these little brass sections looking like that. We've got some washers, so I'll put some of them out. We need some nuts, so I'm putting them out. Now, if you notice, I'm not being tidy with this because we've got so much to build in this section. And we also need some size 17 screws, which are here, and I'll get some of them out as well. Perfect. Okay, so to start off with, we're going to be using one of these brackets that look like that. And again, they do tell us what number pack this comes in. This comes in pack 27. And we're going to be having one of these black washers either side of the end hole in here. So one this side and one this side. Now, on top of that, it's going to get a bit tricky to start off with, but you'll see how this gets a lot easier as we go along. We're going to have one of these brass sections here. So I'll put that on top first. And it's probably best to actually just put the top sections on first, put the size 17 screw through, like this. And you want to make sure all your screws are going the same way, so the heads of the screw here are facing this side of that bracket. Turn it upside down. I'm going to have another washer going onto that screw. Then I'm going to have another one of these brass sections here, looking like that. And then to finish all of that off, I'm going to put a nut just on the end here, just like that. And then tighten that up with the screwdriver. So that's the first piece of the leg completed. Now, the second section of the leg is slightly different. This time what we're going to do is use one of these brass sections again, and that's going to go on top of this section here. Drop a size 17 screw down, but this time in the middle here we're going to have two washers together. So a little bit tricky, but if I put this in first,
Not all the way. Move that one slightly out of the way for a second so I can actually get the washers in, as you can see there. Let me put one washer in there. Another washer in. Make sure they go all the way down, because what I want to do then is the brass section that we had before, we're going to thread that in. I'll just push this down a second so I can get this across. Just like that there. So as you can see how that is. Get another little brass detail over the top here. And then finally, put a nut just on the end to hold all of that into place. Just like that. Make it nice and tight. So as you can see, we've now got two parts of this done. And then we've got the screw heads facing the same direction for the next thing. We're going to continue that all the way down the line here. Now, from the very first segment, we're going to be repeating what we just did on this section here another 13 times so that we've got 15 segments in place. So I think this is probably a good chance to do a speed build. So as you can see, that's 15 segments all in a row there. So it slightly changes when we get to the last ones here. And the changes are basically that we take two of these brass sections and put them together, just like this. That's going to go into the middle of these sections here. We're going to be taking a 15 screw, which is a shorter screw, putting that through the brass section here, and then down the top, brass section on the other side, and then closing that off with a nut. And then the very last one, once again, is just a 15 screw again, but this time this is just going to go into the center of these two parts here, like that. The smaller 15 screw this time, and once again, just another nut on the end. Tighten that up, and there we go. That is one complete leg. And guess what? We've got to repeat that now and do another completed leg, which looks just like that. And because it's an octopus, we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more. So the last thing we're going to do on this stage, we're going to be mounting all these legs to these two dial plates here. And what we want to do is we want to have these plates like that. So they're slightly overlapping with each other. If I just put that down there, what I'm going to do is take one of the legs and make sure this is the hole that I'm interested in here. That's just going to go over the top where these two discs join. Now that's going to be held in with a 17 screw, a washer, and a nut. So what I'll do, get the screw through one side first, just like that. Put that into the first hole here. And obviously the more legs that are in here, the better this is going to hold. Put a washer just over this side. And then the nut over the top of that. And that's the first leg in place. So, second leg, in a similar way to what we did before, screw through this side here. Put that in the opposite hole over the other side here. Washer. And then a nut. So just how you get an idea of how that looks. That's this side. And that's what it looks from this side. And we're just going to repeat that for all the other legs. So when they're all in, it should look like that from this side. And this is what all the legs do. Now, if I was to space these out, just so you can see what sort of effect this gives, you can actually have these molded exactly as you want. Looks a lot like a spider. But you get the idea. It's pretty cool, isn't it? But I think we're going to leave it there. Quite a lot of work, and you do get black fingers when you're doing this, but I think that looks really good. And then the top section will eventually hold the globe here, as you can see. I think that's going to look really good.
So there you go. I hope you enjoyed that video. And part two will hopefully be out in the next couple of weeks. And I think it's great that we're going to be able to mount either a lamp or an Echo Dot or whatever you can think of that will fit in that space as the head unit for this mechanical octopus. But once again, the links for that are in the video description with the discount codes. You can get this for yourself. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.